What's happening, Rise of 44 here on Nalyo Gaming. In this video, we're going to be checking out Goodbye Deponia on the PlayStation 4. Let's jump right in. Alright, so we have continue, new game, load save, settings, bonus, and credits. Let's go new game.
Has confirmed that the Organon is ready to fulfill its mission. As soon as the inspection team give the all clear on the return from the ruins of Porto Fisco, nothing will stand in the way of the spectacular start of our journey to Utopia. It is only a matter of hours until we can finally give the Organon the signal to go ahead and blow up our home planet. The good news is, due to this delay, the water slide will stay open for now.
They're all happy about the water slide. I was waiting for this.
So this is the third strike, you're dumping me just like a trash bag. Why? Just because of some must. Tart on the carpet, you pathetic doghead. I assume that your humor did just bite the dust. But this isn't over yet. Yeah, you can bet on that. The last part of my day will surely appease and change your mind anyhow. So turn on your deaf aid now. The story goes on, for good things come in threes.
For saga things come in threes.
Huzzah, good things come. We got a bronze PlayStation trophy.
Hey, wait a minute. Smoke!
Alright, we got Goal sleeping.
Fire!
What?
Fire!
Good morning, ladies.
Doc, the fire extinguisher. I'll wake those and get the mine detector.
Take it easy. I'm just making breakfast here.
Fried sludge with honey. Oh, not again.
Got an eye.
The allergy medication is in the cupboard with the bear trap.
Nonsense. The sludge is just the bait. I am fishing. At this very moment, I'm using the diving crane to catch something big.
Oh, goody. That's a new one.
No problem. Let me think.
We should be in the Sea of Shards by now.
Do we have enough bandages left?
Doc?
Yes?
This isn't the Sea of Shards.
What?
Oh, right. I forgot to tell you. I hatched a great plan while you were asleep.
What have you done?
I found an abandoned on-ramp for the Organon's monorail track. And so I thought to myself, Bozo's cutter used to be a rail vehicle, right?
Rufus!
What?
You've steered us onto an Organon cruiser route.
Yeah, and it'll take us directly to the Upper Ascension Station in Porto Fisco.
Where the Organon's headquarters are.
And where the last high boat to Elysium is anchored. That was the plan, wasn't it? I will use my amazing resemblance to Cletus to sneak on board, together with Gold.
But...
So come on, let's eat something first. That's the diving crane. I've got a bite.
I thought we weren't on the water anymore.
So what?
What do you mean, so what? So what took the bait?
Uh-oh.
Well.
Oh, crap. I guess this means Bozo will finally accept the fact that he needs a new cutter.
Oh, Rufus, you were so right. You are such a good friend.
Ha, it's his own fault. What a lard bag.
All right, so just real quick, if you're not familiar with Deponia, if you're just checking out this video and it's your first time even seeing anything to do with this universe, Deponia has had two games prior to this. We had Deponia, and then we had Chaos on Deponia, and now we're playing Goodbye Deponia. It's a pretty interesting series. The story's absolutely crazy, and it's nuts. If you want a recap of all the games so far, I'll link below. I got a couple of videos I put out, as well as some other recap videos. But yeah, let's jump into this gameplay and we'll see what happens. I like that it starts out right here, exactly where Chaos and Deponia left off. Basically, to give you like a really, really quick summary, we had this main character here trying to save the day. We got some bad people that wanted to blow up our planet, and they were going to go lie about there being no inhabitants of the planet, and well, it was inhabited. So he's just been constantly trying to save the day, but he's kind of a goof and screws up every time. So
two lights are blinking on the radar screen, a small green one in the middle and a big red one behind it. It can only mean one thing: we're out of confetti.
All right, on deck into the cutter. So as you can tell, this is a point-and-click adventure game.
Uh-oh.
What's kept you, Argus? I was just talking to the Elysian Council of Elders. They're starting to get nervous.
We're on our way, Prime Controller. Inspector Cletus and his companion are on board. There will be no further delays.
I should very much hope so. Ulysses, over.
Treason! Stop the engines, Argus.
Cletus, you have no business here. You're supposed to stay in the cabin until we reach Porto Fisco.
That will have to wait. This woman is not my fiancée.
Put his eyeballs in the waffle iron.
I know that. She's a Deponian with a brain implant, which also happens to contain the cartridge with the mind of your fiancée.
No, it doesn't. Do you think this sounds like gold?
Chew flesh from their ankles! Rotten vinegar!
Maybe she's about to have, a visit from Aunt Flo.
Rubbish. That Rufus pulled a fast one on me. We need to turn back.
You fool. Excuse me, bailiff, sir. There's something on the track. What do I care? Run it over. We have no time to lose. The inspector has forgotten something important, and he's in trouble if he can't find it soon. Oppenbot, you will go with Inspector Cletus.
As you wish, bailiff.
Okay.
Phew! Goal! Goal! Hang on, I'm coming!
Wow, they throw you right back into it.
Out!
Oh, jeez.
And... what? Hi! The crane might break at any moment. I need to do something. Anything. You've chosen a romantic location.
Well, you refused to go to the theater.
Yeah, at least the seats would have been more comfortable.
For starters, you might want to tighten the screws. In the meantime, I'll try to free the cable.
Consider it done. Huh? Hey!
Uh-oh.
Oops.
They're just going back and forth. We already lost one.
Oh, yeah, there is some progress, so to speak.
Uh-oh.
What have you done?
Wasn't me.
Damn it, Rufus, we're going to fall.
No, we won't.
I'm slipping.
He's such a screw up.
I've gotcha.
Hold on to goal. Oh man, he took her he took her clothes right off. Jesus.
Ow. Well, well, who have we here?
What the heck?
That's Rufus, of course.
Don't you know anything?
Who are you?
Oh, just a fan. Don't pay any attention to me.
A what? A fan?
Exactly. Just carry on, will you? But just a teeny tiny question first. How are you going to get rid of it?
How? What?
You know, what spectacular Rufus maneuver are you going to use?
Oh, that.
I'm going to blindside him with a special karate kick. I'm going to tie his shoelaces together. I'll confuse him with my blackout tactics. A pro never reveals his tricks. No plan. Mixed suggestion. I'll confuse him with my blackout. A pro never reveals.
A pro never reveals his tricks.
Oh, come on. How else would I know what F-stop to use?
Hello? What's the big idea? Can't you see we're busy?
Exactly. But the photo?
Go ahead and tell him what you're planning to do so we can get on with it.
Alright, no plan, make a suggestion.
No plan? Make a suggestion.
Good one! I mean, you're Rufus! You've always got a plan!
Oh, right. You've got a point there. I'm gonna tie his shoelaces together.
Ah, a close-up shot. Just let me mount my telephoto lens.
Did you sprain a sprocket or something? I don't have shoelaces.
Abort! I've got my telephoto lens here, but the adapter is missing. Can we have that shoelace thing on the back burner?
Yeah, whatever. I'll confuse him with my blackout tactics.
Ah, a residual light shot. Need to set my flash to the highest level.
Blackout? You're bluffing.
Perhaps I am. Perhaps I definitely am.
I'll switch on my night vision equipment just in case.
There! Done! Do your thing, Rufus!
Man, this is gonna be so epic!
Okay. One, two...
I'm blind! What?
Saw that happening.
And...
His laugh is great.
Ta-da!
Wow! You actually did it!
Yeah. Ta-da!
Ah, that's me, you know.
How on earth did you do that?
Wait for the photo.
And now you're gonna go save Gold, right?
Who? Oh, her, sure.
How are you gonna do that?
One thing at a time. The two of us should have a talk first.
We should?
Yeah, fan to idol.
Wow, what an honor!
She's just spinning in the background. He's talking about.
What are you doing aboard an Organon cruiser?
That's a pretty interesting story.
Too bad it's not about me. Let's discuss more exciting stuff. For instance, what about my exploits?
Oh, boy!
So, you're a fan of mine.
My name is Barry. I traveled for miles only so I could talk to my greatest idol. Just this once.
Well, then let me talk instead of boring me with the story of your empty life.
He's such a prick.
We should use the time for an interview.
Really? Shouldn't you be saving Gold first?
Her. All in good time. A true hero must take care of his fan base.
Wow. You really are the greatest.
Did you hear about the time I saved Goal from the claws of the Organon?
Sure. The story about how you caught her when she fell from the sky is legendary. almost as legendary as your selfless decision to take her back to Elysium, completely disregarding your own best interest.
Legendary? It's epic. Do you realize it was me who started the rebellion against the Organon?
Who else? In the floating black market, you had the idea to look for comrades in arms to fight against the Dark Exchequer. That's where you recruit Janosch, Garleth, and Liebold, who happened to be floating past in a pickle barrel.
Gosh, even those are the things I made up. Do you know how I uncovered the Organon's conspiracy?
Well, of course! You fought your way through hundreds of Organon soldiers to beat the truth out of Cletus. That's how you learned that the Elysians are planning to blast Deponia to pieces. But they have no idea that Deponia is inhabited. Prime Controller Ulysses and Argos, his henchmen, are keeping this fact a secret. And they got Cletus to falsify his report to reflect that.
Wow, sounds like you were there. Have you also heard that I prevented the depopulation of the Rust Red Sea?
Naturally! You led the rebel attack against an Organon blast tower. You blocked the bomb suspension clamps all by yourself, and then you proceeded to save Gol from the claws of her devious would-be fiancé, Cletus.
That's exactly how it happened.
Hey, we got another PlayStation trophy. Remembrance of things past, bronze PlayStation trophy.
What else would you like to know?
Actually, I already know it all. I would much prefer to watch you perform a new feat of heroism.
You already know it all? Don't make me laugh. How about a little photo session?
Oh, fantastic!
Let's see. What would be a suitable subject?
I could take a picture of you saving Gold.
Yeah, but then she would be in the picture too.
He's so self-centered.
Unnecessarily from the protagonist.
Quite on the contrary, it would emphasize your selflessness.
You think so? All right, then get ready and make sure my selflessness is clearly visible in the picture.
All right.
I've got to get her down from there and fast. I can barely see her underwear. The cannon is aiming directly at the axle. How refreshingly careless. Wait, Gol, I'll shoot you free!
But you're a crap shot!
Yeah, I'm a crack shot! Dang, the cannon's aim is off.
Ingenious! You found the cruiser's manual speed control!
Exactly! The manual thingamy.
I feel another brilliant Rufus maneuver coming up!
Yeah, can you try to feel it without making so much noise?
Alright, speed up. Slow down.
Are you going to start the extreme action now?
The what?
Well, the action! A super extreme Rufus maneuver!
Yeah, exactly. Totally extreme.
This is so exciting!
Are you going to start
the...
Well, a super...
This is so...
Wouldn't let me slow it down.
I see! You're accelerating the cruiser instead of stopping it like everyone else would have done.
That's because everyone else is an idiot.
And the cutter being caught in the cogs is part of your plan as well, right?
Sure. Aw, bummer. No more ammo. Are you excited?
Like an egg in a platypus egg catapult.
Hey, how long have you been watching me? Whoa, that's incredibly appropriate. A fan. Why did it take so long? I've got to get her down from... I can barely see her underwear. Go! I will save you! What are you saying? My soul.
She's calling me an asshole.
To you, my selfless hero? I can't understand a word.
What else do we have? I think this is it.
Please! See those sparks fly!
He's on fire too.
Faster still! This is so rad! My coat is on fire, but I'm still very happy to be part of this. Luckily, the Organon is
ludicrous speed. Bronze PlayStation trophy.
Dad, that's just propaganda. I bet my boots. Your boots.
Knocks him out.
Maximum speed already? Yeah, that's the Organon for you. Spoils cords. Huh. The cannon. How refreshingly.
Go. There we go.
What do you say? No, I can't.
There we go.
I would have made an excellent fireman. Even the fact that there's always fire near me.
All right, we have an axe.
I would have made an excellent fireman. Even the fact. I would have made even the fact.
What is going on right now?
For this, I need nothing but my fingers and my legendary ability to ignore the call of reason.
Lever, hose. We want the hose.
Yeah, she's hot.
Come on. Why isn't it letting me grab the hose? What is going on right now? Oh, okay. Why?
Go! I will. What do you say? It's already loaded. Go. What do you? My son. Yeah. Okay. 10 zlotys a ride, plus 2 zlotys with surcharge. I'm the only one who gets to ride for free. Not before I've submitted the pass. Aw, bummer. No more ammo. Maximum. Yeah, that's poor. For this, I need. And. I would have made an excellent fireman, even the fact. 10 slotting the ride, plus 2. I'm the only one who gets. Not before I've submitted the pass. I promised Goal I would never throw axes at her again, although I'm sure she regrets that now.
Daring sharpshooter, bronze PlayStation trophy.
I promised Goal I would, although I'm sure. I promised Goal I.
What do I do then? I mean, I don't really have any other options. Some of these puzzles are super hard to figure out, and then to other people, they're really obvious.
I promise to go, although I've got to get her down from there, and fast. I can barely see her underwear. I promise to go. Aw, bummer. Aw, bummer. Maximum speed. Yeah, that's you, boy. For this and my.
Okay, so nothing there, nothing here.
I promise to go, although I'm.
She. It won't let me throw the axe at her.
I would have made it.
Not at her, but.
Not before I've submitted the pack. I call it the 10 slotty the robust 2. I'm the only.
I swear I tried that like 5 times.
Daredevil! Hold! Still!
What a hero!
Did someone leave the window open?
Jesus. It's so ridiculous. Love it.
So the cutter struck sails, wrecked Estonia's mum scales, and of as much a whale for the long road ahead. Still the mood in the group was just super, whoopee-doo, yeah, except that they slowly grew ripe for the bad. For they knew that they would have to go on by foot. And no problem for such a walk is all the less stressful if you sing along with a motivating song. And to emphasize this, I flap the cabin of the coast guys with helium gas.
Huzzah with helium gas. Sound like the Munchkins. Did we make it back? Where are we now? Huzzah with helium gas, bronze PlayStation trophy. That's like four PlayStation trophies within the first few minutes of the game. Ha! Maybe five.
Yeah! And wow! The way I took out that Organon with my shadow attack! Did you see that?
For the thousandth time, Rufus.
That was so cool! They call him Rufus! Rufus!
Oh.
Everybody now, he's cool and he's smart! It's something, something modern art! What? Hey! Where are you going?
There's a hotel down there. I really need a wash. Especially for my ears.
But... Goal?
Come on, Rufus.
Are you mad at me?
Dirty, battered, humiliated, all of that. But mad at you? No.
She's used to it.
It was actually kind of cool.
She encourages him.
Oh, yeah! Something, something modern art!
He's such an idiot. I wonder where the fan is with the camera. Where'd he go?
Haha, stairs. Dark and steep and slippery. Huh. I better take a jump. After all, I hate to...
I better take a jump. Oh, man.
Fall on my butt. That would be too embarrassing.
All right, to the cruiser route. All right, where else? What's this? To reception. To the rooms. To laundry. Bathroom? Toilet.
I've seen worse crappers than that.
Occupied.
Are you ever coming out of there?
Don't rush me. I'm suffering from severe temporal diarrhea.
Temporal diarrhea?
Yes, I'm a time traveler.
You mean you come from the future?
Nonsense. Oh, hold on.
Jesus.
There is no future. I came from the past to watch the end of the world.
Here we go again. Then you're in the wrong place. I'm the guy who's gonna prevent the end of the world.
Oh! That would be very nice of you. I'm stuck here, you know.
Why? Is your time machine clogged?
Not exactly. There's no more toilet paper.
Hey. That was irony. Naturally, I don't believe a word you've said.
Well, it wasn't exactly the whole truth.
Ha! I knew it!
There's one roll of toilet paper left, but it's as rough as sandpaper. Oh, and I had the chili during the Toxican Civil War. Oh.
Come on, man. Thank God that's over. That was brutal.
Hey, what's going on here?
Home, hum, kumbaya.
Okay. Hello, you, you friendly hooded people who clearly belong to a, non-violent organization. Are you standing in line for the washing machine?
Home, hum, kumbaya.
Dooba 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 dabba dooba da. You wouldn't mind if I go first, right? Okay. Act weird once for sure, no problem, pal.
Home, hum, kumbaya.
Cool. Then if I could just
home, hum, kumbaya, no.
Darn.
Alright, so we got Bozo's suit outside. Okay, we got something down there. Washing machine. What's this? Woolly platypus? What was that? Was that a secret?
That's pretty huge, considering there isn't a single bit of clean laundry in the entire hotel. Wow! Freshly washed! I don't see a difference. I can still hang my things up to dry when all my plans to save the world have gone down the drain. These things are extremely well suited for digging bits of banana out of high voltage outlets.
Jesus. Alright, now we got a hanger too. Those will come in handy. Mysterious laundry secret.
How about a little trade?
Home, hum, kumbaya, no.
But I didn't even tell you what I...
Home, hum, kumbaya, who cares?
Yeah, you have no idea what you're missing out on. You know, open flames in a laundromat is it's really not a good idea. That could burn down half the village. And then everybody points at you again. And they take away your flamethrower. And fire the friendly preschool teacher for failing to provide proper supervision. excuse me. Is this going to take long?
Home, hum, kumbaya.
Darn.
What else do we have? Outside.
How about a little trade?
Home, hum.
But I didn't even...
Home.
Washing machine.
Excuse me. I need to use the washing machine.
Home, hum, kumbaya, no.
Darn. That's pretty huge. Consider.
Alright, back outside. We're obviously gonna come back here at some point. Long-haired platypus. That's the second one we found.
Through this door, and he will bear the sign of the beast.
I know that voice. That's...
And a dull knocking will precede his arrival, and he will say... Ow!
Oh, that's gonna leave a bum. Hey, don't mock me. You... Wait a second. I know you. You're...
Very busy.
No, you're the guy with the pipe. The soothsayer from Porto Fisco.
No, I'm not.
You're a liar.
Which basically disqualify me from being a soothsayer, doesn't it?
That's just hair splitting.
He is the fortune teller. What do you... Are you planning on going on a journey? What was the mumbling just now? What's with the strange outfit? You don't happen to know those guys from the laundry room.
You don't happen to know those guys from the laundry room?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Well, they're carrying candles, singing in minor keys, and they're wearing the same outfit as you.
Well, I wouldn't worry about it. Probably just a harmless glee club.
They painted a pentagram on the floor.
Ah, circle of fifths. No doubt about it.
Ah! I still think you're the fortune teller.
Ah, I'm often confused with someone else. For example, with Ansgar Meatcap, the famous hat model.
Are you pulling my leg?
Why? We go to the same barber.
Come on, I recognize you. What are you hiding?
Nothing. Unlike Ansgar, that vain fop.
What's with the strange outfit? Are you in some weird sect?
This is just a bathrobe from the hotel.
Oh yeah? Did the hotel also embroider "The End is Nigh" on there?
They mean the end of the early bird booking period. The end of the early bird booking period is nigh. Book your vacation at Hotel Menetekel now.
Stop pretending. I see through you.
Oh dear. That was to be expected. Of course, you were right. I am the fortune teller. But I don't like to use my abilities.
Oh yeah, there's nothing but junk on for the future, right?
More precisely, there's nothing on. The world is coming to an end.
Huh?
Yes, that was also my first reaction. The second was to pack all my things up and run away.
But that's nonsense.
I know. One cannot escape one's fate.
Exactly. You have to
come to terms with it.
What? No!
That is why I gathered like-minded people around me, to prepare for the unavoidable together.
You founded an apocalyptic sect?
Hey, can you think of a better time?
What makes you think the world will come to an end?
The signs were clear. Last night, the horizon was in flames.
Oh, you don't mean my barbecue, do you?
Then, it rained fire from the heavens.
Yeah, okay. I shouldn't have used the cheap briquettes.
And frogs?
I told Doc they weren't done yet.
Finally, the water of the ocean turned to blood.
Okay, I get it. My little barbecue party got a bit out of control. So what?
To Dracula.
But that doesn't make me a horseman of the apocalypse. Yeah, I know it said so on the flyer, but that was just for PR. The world won't end today.
Correct. It will happen tomorrow, shortly before the late news.
Ha! Huh, not if I can prevent it.
Also true. Unfortunately, you can't.
We'll see about that.
Wrong. Our eyes will have long since burned away when it happens.
Oh, you know better about everything, huh?
Yes. An occupational hazard.
What are you doing here anyway?
I am preparing for my big speech. The world doesn't come to an end every day. I want to look good.
I think you look just fine.
Oh, you think so? No, something's not quite right yet. Perhaps I should pluck my eyebrows again.
Can I have your robe?
No, but if you participate in our ritual, you will get your own.
Are you nuts? There's absolutely no way I'm going to take part in your eerie apocalyptic sock hop.
It is a self-purification ritual to cleanse you of your sins. It is a matter of symbolically washing ourselves clean of our sins before the end comes.
What sins? I'm busy saving the world. Strictly speaking, I'm sort of a saint, and I already washed this week.
I have seen it otherwise.
Your pals are clogging up the laundry.
Patience, my friend. The ritual won't take long.
Yeah? What are they waiting for, then? I need to use the washing machine.
Well, they are waiting for their guru, of course, for me.
Then what are you doing here?
I am preparing for my big speech. The world doesn't come to an end every day. I want to look good.
I'm gonna put a stop to your bunch of superstitious yahoos.
But we aren't doing anything wrong.
Oh, of course not. You just want to call down the end of the world.
Oh, we do not. The end can no longer be stopped. All that is left to us is to prepare for it spiritually.
Spiritually? I see. So you're getting hammered. A sort of rap party for the planet.
Quite the contrary.
What the hell?
Of symbolically washing ourselves clean of our...
So just soft drinks? I'd rather go to the real Satanists. At least they know how to party. Yeah, you're beyond help.
As are we all.
Okay.
Absurd humor is okay in itself, but I can't waste this unique opportunity on another cheap pun. I'm thinking of the fans who love my prank. Mr. Toffee. Weird name for a tarantula. Hope it's not connected to its camouflage.
Hey! Leave Mr. Toffee alone. Hey! Leave Mr. Toffee alone.
I knew I'd seen that ugly mug somewhere before. At first, I thought it was at the bowling alley. No idea why. Could I bother you again?
Yes.
Tia.
As are we all. I see that you give yourself a break. Your fate is already written.
That may be, but that could mean anything. Like taking candy from a baby, just with fewer cavities.
Alright, we got toothpaste.
Yeah! That would be funny. But I can't waste this unique opportunity on another cheap pun. I'm thinking of the fact.
Alright, so we want to. Yeah.
But I can't.
That would be funny. Put to put the toothpaste in his hood and then make him put it on. All right, I think we're done here. That's just the first room. What is there? Five rooms? Six? Five?
This pillowcase is full of lice. It's suitable for exactly two things. First, to get a daycare center under quarantine, and second, to cover a pillow.
All right, bookcase, door to room.
There's nobody here.
That's nice. Then I can come in.
What? No, stop.
Too late.
Whose room is this?
Hello? You there? Under the sheet.
There's nobody under the sheet.
Don't be silly. I can see you.
You're seeing a ghost?
Can't be. I don't believe in ghosts. Especially not the creepy sort that hang around in dark hotel rooms and are eternally trapped between worlds until their poor souls finally find release.
I'm not a ghost, and it would be a release if you would...
Not so hasty. If you aren't a ghost, in the dark, right next to that peephole into the next room.
Ooh, go away! Or unless, of course, you're from room service.
I am room for... I'm Rufus. I'm the hotel exorcist. I'm just curious. I'm not superstitious. I'm already gone.
I'm the hotel exorcist. Please immediately cease and desist all haunting activities and slowly and decently depart the sphere of the living.
Alas, I can't do that.
I see. Yeah, I hear that a lot. You're one of those restless souls.
Aren't we all? in one way or another.
No, not me. I'm leaving this dreary planet.
Congratulations. Why don't you practice by leaving this? After all, you have no business being here. Unless, of course, you're from room service.
I am room.
Very well. Then please clear away the dishes by the door.
Huh? But there aren't any dishes.
Oh, those dishes. Okay, what do we got here?
Hey, stay by the door where I can see you.
Well, I thought I was supposed to go away.
Yes.
Hey, can't you make up your mind? Before...
Oh, my. This is where the sheet hits the fan.
The sheet.
Hey, why does a ghost need room service? To change the sheets.
Keep your hands off my sheet.
Sure thing. I can imagine how uncomfortable it is when the edge gets tucked so far under the mattress. A friend of mine once got caught in a laminating machine. He cried all night. Fortunately, I remembered how to shut the machine off.
But as I said, this is not about the sheet. Just clear away the dish.
And why do you need dishes?
For a midnight snack?
Oh, yeah. Logic. Can I turn on the light?
There is no light here. Only darkness.
Charm?
Shame!
Oh, yeah, charm. I'm very charming.
No shame!
Yeah, shame, of course. Those little, shame-shaped things. I don't think you're a ghost.
And how, may I ask, did you come to that conclusion?
Ghosts only appear to those who blame themselves for something. They're sort of like a guilty conscience made material.
Guilty conscience? Me? You have some ideas.
You better believe me. I blame myself for absolutely nothing.
Oh, come on. Everybody has some guilty secret.
Yeah, I don't have any guilty secrets. Why else would Gold take me with her to Elysium? In the short time we've known each other, I've already thrown her from a moving Organon cruiser twice, poured espresso made from battery acid down her throat, split her mind into three, and this morning, I accidentally grouted the baby turtle she tried to nurse back to health with quick-drying cement. But my conscience is clear.
Have you ever thought that maybe it isn't a matter of whether this goal forgives you, but whether you forgive
cement.
Yourself?
Whoa! That would be totally egotistical.
I don't think so.
Oh, man.
All right. What's your guilty secret, then?
Isn't it obvious?
You're a bedwetter?
Rubbish. Look at where I am.
In a dark hotel room.
Next to...
a hole in the wall.
And what does that tell you?
You're peeping Tom.
You like to drill holes.
Oh, my gosh.
Whoa.
Huh? But, wait a second. You don't mean...
Yep, I like to listen to people while they sing in the shower.
Oh, man. He just laughs out. Oh, shoot. Whoever wrote this. Oh, man.
Ah, guilty schmilty. Let's talk about something else.
Gladly.
And I'm sticking with it. No haunting without a guilty secret.
Yes, and...
okay, fine. I forgive myself. There. And now?
What? And now?
Well, you're still here. If you were really a manifestation of my guilty conscience, wouldn't you have dissolved now, or...
Maybe I have to forgive myself.
Of course. Just like in My Friend the Phantom Astronaut. Come on, hop to it. Just forgive yourself.
It's not that. I am really very ashamed of...
Well... how are you going to find redemption, then?
Well, I thought I'd just stand here in the dark and fight against it.
Oh, man, what a crybaby. Yeah, what was your guilt?
I like to listen to people while they sing in the shower.
Oh, man.
Gladly.
Hey, nice.
Keep your hands off my.
Do you need it, my.
As long as you're here.
Well, I was just.
I should be so lucky.
Excuse me?
Oh,
that's better.
Boo.
Hey, stay.
Well, I thought I was supposed to go away.
Yes.
Hey,
I... Let's see. What else is there? Dishes? Yeah.
Ow! Shards! Ow! Another shard!
And... Uh-huh! This isn't a shard. It's a knife.
We got a knife now. Okay. Ooh, we have a knife.
Hey,
well, I thought I...
Yes!
Hey! Why would a ghost need a fish knife?
Is it to rattle?
And I thought they were serving nothing but fish in the great beyond.
Okay, I think we're done here. I think. That took forever. Oh, wow. Let's check the rest of the rooms before we go in there. What's this? To the pie vending machine.
Huh, locked. Bozo? No answer. Huh, locked. Doc? No answer. But there's somebody in there. I hear voices. I can think of a thousand ways to crack this lock, but the designer seems to have foreseen all of them. Apparently, word of my skills has gotten around. Goal? No answer. I can think of a thousand, but it is apparently...
Okay, so... Alright. Lever, left button, middle button. Okay, what do we need? Lever. What's this one do? Button on the diagonal. How do we... Let's see. Do we have to... get all of them? Maybe we just have to get... either light them all up, or there's gotta be a pattern. Has to be a pattern.
Who needs change when he's got magic fingers and an undeniable knack for vending machines of every sort? Ouch. What a bummer! The vending machine only takes coins.
Okay. Is there anything I can do with that diagram? Let's see. I don't think there is. Yeah, I don't think there is. Shoot. Heater.
The red modules are set to heat, but that's such a waste of energy. Let's see if I can turn them off. For this, I need nothing but my fingers, time-tested deductive skills, or alternatively, lots of patience.
Button on the side.
Thank you.
Oh, I thought that was gonna do it too.
For this time test or alter.
Whoa, 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 go back, go back, go back. There's gotta be a pattern. Really? What the heck? Oh, I thought I had it. Man, every time I think I have it, I'm off.
Did it! Rufus 1, entropy 0.
That took forever.
Who needs change when he's got magic fingers and an undeniable knack for vending machines of every sort? Ouch.
So what, do I have to find a coin now?
Whoa! With a fun slime troll and one out of every 5 pies! Rad! And all these years, I thought they weren't allowed to make these anymore. What a bummer.
I mean, to be completely honest, I was trying to turn them all red, but turning them all blue is just as well. I need to find a coin, I think.
What were they thinking? Putting a dumpster for fish guts right under the guest rooms when there's a perfect balcony to throw stuff over. You can find the craziest stuff in the trash. Huh, a pelican. That's not crazy. Mildly odd, maybe. Huh, doesn't seem to like that, although the same is true for the fish guts. May I? I'm pretty snappy for somebody who doesn't have any teeth, but just you wait. I'll stuff your big mouth. The last thing that's missing here is table manners. May I?
Okay, what's next? It's the same thing, just the other side. Okay. Let's go to the office. Where is everyone? Like, my whole crew is just not to the restaurant. There we go. Okay, that's where everyone probably is, I'm guessing.
For this, I need nothing but my fingers and superhuman immunity against pathogens of any sort.
My circuits are scrambled. I shouldn't get up so fast.
Or get a little exercise.
Whoa! Don't creep up on me like that!
Creep? I rang the bell.
Phew! I thought it was my tinnitus. It wouldn't surprise me, though, with all that noise from the cruiser route, not to mention the cold draft or the mold, but I digress. Welcome to the Hotel Menetekel. Would you like to rent a room?
Actually, I was just looking for my friends.
A geriatric garden gnome, a girly giraffe, and a circus bear in a hat?
That's them.
Yeah, they just checked in. They didn't look like they could afford a lawyer, so I gave them room 5. But don't worry. As long as they don't touch any light switches, electrical sockets, or load-bearing architecture, they should survive the night. Provided they stay in their room after midnight, of course. Which reminds me, do you happen to have unfinished business with demons, dark gods, or the recently dead?
Not that I know of.
Super! That's all right then. You have no idea how squeamish some insurance companies can be when it comes to supernatural causes of death. Here's your key. Please have a pleasant stay here at Hotel Menetekel.
thank you, my good man. Are you insinuating that this place is haunted?
Not at all. We're safe here in reception. It's the rooms I'd worry about, especially room 13.
Why? What's wrong with room 13?
Let's just say it was a mistake to bury the Indians there. Oh, yeah, and an apocalyptic cult has occupied the laundry. So if you need clean bedding, you should make sure you don't carry any religious insignia or virgins with you.
Haven't you heard the rumor that Deponia is going to be blown up?
Of course. That's why popcorn is sold out everywhere.
Well, it's all true. But I'm the one who's going to prevent it.
That's fantastic. Yeah.
What?
For one thing, I was forced to clean the toilet this week.
Is that supposed to be a joke?
Got me. Of course I didn't clean the toilet. That'll be the day.
Hello, I'm talking about the greatest catastrophe of all time.
Ah, so you've already seen our toilet.
Menetekel.
You'd think so? It's Menetekel. I've always thought the name was cute. It means something like impending doom.
That's
why
is
the clock getting faster?
Don't we all do that?
Right, but if you have a choice.
But you don't. Or have you seen another hotel?
Strange location for a hotel, right under the Organon cruiser route.
You think so?
Ugh. People without a sense of smell?
People who are so desperate that they'll accept anything.
Them. How will I find my room?
Oh, probably horrible. I wouldn't want to spend the night in there.
Oh, why do I bother? I'm going to my...
Yeah, do that. I won't stop. And before you ask, that does not constitute an act of negligent bodily harm. We've had that checked.
For this, I'm an super...
Be right there.
I like his work attitude. It's fact...
They're not here either. What the heck? Steals the salt and pepper, of course.
Let's see if there's anything left in here. There actually was something left in there. Dust.
Dusty old coffee maker.
I usually take my coffee black, but it only seems to come in gray-green here.
Ugh.
And once again, it is shown that art is the antonym of artifice. Disappointing art. very disappointing. I don't think much of modern art. It's drawn from the perspective of a person who unsuspectingly opens the urn of his dear departed mother and then dies of a heart attack because of the spring-loaded flowers popping out at him. What a pity it's hanging so crooked. I don't think it's drawn. And what a pity it's hanging. Aha! Here we have the perpetrator. Huh, a nut. Who needs tools when he has hands like vice grips? Pretty slippery, my vice grips. Who needs tools? Pretty. That would work. Not. That would work. Not. Yeah, that would not. Who needs t- pretty slippery, my. Who needs t- pretty slip. Who needs two? Pretty slippery, my vice grip. Oh, sure, that would work. Not.
All right, so I need tools.
That would not.
Okay. Definitely need tools.
I don't need any coffee for the current phase of my plan. And conveniently, that's what we have here. No coffee. Time for the next phase.
Okay. Cruiser route. Where's the rooms again? Right here. Room 5. Which one's 5? One of these, right?
Doc? No answer.
Which one's 5?
Doc? No answer.
Let's see.
Goal? No answer. It fits.
All right, that's my room.
Ah, okay. There you are. And wow, what is all this stuff? Did you just set it up?
No. Neurofusion chambers are standard in this hotel. Of course we did.
Huh, pretty speedy. And what does one do with a neuro thingy? Can you watch scrambled channels?
That too. But most importantly, it will repair Gold's brain implant.
Brain?
You know, remerging the aspects of her character.
Yes?
Her entire consciousness was stored on a cartridge.
Right, together with the ascension codes.
That you need to gain access to the high boat. Exactly. After this procedure, Gold will be her old self again.
And then you can make use of the shower.
Shower? Why?
For the Ascension customs? Or did you think they'd let you into Elysium like that?
What? And just what is that supposed to mean?
I'm just saying, considering everything we know about that Cletus, he is an extremely clean person. So, if you want to pretend to be him, shower.
Hey, let me deal with that. You take care of Goal, or do I have to help you with that as well?
Not necessary. It's almost ready.
Cool.
I need that wrench.
Almost? Where's the catch?
Catch? No such thing. I just have to calibrate the data interface.
And once again, I have to do all the heavy lifting, right?
Not at all.
No problem. I can fillet a data thingy with one hand tied behind my back.
You just... Rufus, no! That throttles the fuel rods.
Ah, they can handle it.
Rufus, this calibration is really much too easy for you. Why don't you take care of the much more difficult professional mission?
Professional mission?
Of course. Doc still needs this thing that can't be found in this hotel room.
Oh, exactly.
They're trying to get rid of... He's so stupid.
Plasma...
exchange.
Whoop-de-doo.
Whoop-de-doo.
Mammoth fur.
Relay.
A plasma exchange whoop-de-doo mammoth fur relay? Hard to come by. Huh, for beginners like you, maybe, but for a pro like me, it'll only take a jiffy.
Alright. Can we save? Save. Okay. We have our first save. So that's where I'm going to end my first gameplay with Goodbye Deponia here on the PlayStation 4. I do appreciate you watching on Nalyo Gaming. If you haven't already done so, please click that like button. Let me know in the comment section what you think. Share with your friends. Follow me on Twitter at RiseUp44 and at Nalyo Gaming. And please consider subscribing to me here on Nalyo Gaming. So just to let you guys know, I was provided with a game key thanks to Daedalic Entertainment. I'm super pumped to be playing again. This is, like I mentioned earlier, the third game in the series to launch on the PlayStation 4. There's one more that I'm aware of that's going to be coming out shortly after this one launches, and we'll definitely jump into that. For now, we're going to jump back in, play some more. I'll definitely post it here on Nalyo Gaming for you all to see. We'll get through this gameplay, record a couple more episodes for Goodbye Deponia, see where this story leads us, and we'll go from there. I'm really enjoying it so far. It's an acquired taste. Some people really love these point-and-click games. I love puzzle games. I love games like this. I always have since I was a kid, and I just can't wait to play more. If you're excited to see more gameplay, let me know in the comment section. Click that like button. But yeah, that's going to do it for this first video with Goodbye Deponia. I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.